All right, so now Brad is gonna get a workout. That's Brad Barrett back there in the bass. So I was a pianist for a long time and eventually kind of let that go and majored in percussion studies. But kind of the end of my piano career, my lesson taking, I was working on the Gershwin's piano preludes. So Gershwin wrote 3 piano preludes. Apparently he was going for 24. I only got 3 done. 1/8, not bad. I know what that's like to start a project and then it doesn't finish. But they're awesome. And they're often done as like recital like closers or encore type pieces. And looking for material that we could kind of adopt here, I was like, wow, this would actually like really fit for the band. The range of the piano is kind of covered in all the instruments that we have here. And so I decided to take the preludes, but just when I kind of arranged them, it was a little dry and just kind of like it didn't feel like substantial enough for us to kind of take it on. So I was like, well, time to do something to them. So we decided to orchestraticize them. So the first one, basically what we did is we just put a groove on it. So this was, the first prelude is based in a Brazilian rhythm called baião. And baião is from the northeast of Brazil. It's a dance rhythm. And so we basically put this into the groove, and Jeremy and I are gonna play, you know, some of the percussion parts that would typically go under the baião dance style under this. And then the second prelude is my favorite. It's actually a ballad, and there's a little tribute to cats in this. So I love cats, and you're gonna hear a very famous scene of a couple cats that are gonna interrupt the recital, the piano recital, and have a cat fight. So you'll hear that in the second prelude. And in the third prelude, there's a little interjection of Bulgarian women's choral singing, as well as Aaron Copland tribute. So little American everything, you know, stir the pot again. And one of the fun things about this is, again, trying to think of how we could bring something to Gershwin's music. I was like, well, Brad actually used to play classical bass. Brad's very big into contemporary improv and very modern jazz music, but he also reads. So one of the challenges that I've had with this group over the years is really finding the best players that can improvise and play off the page, but also can read all this crazy crap that's going on. There's a lot of ink, and especially with piano music, especially like a recital closer, they're chopsy, you know, they have a lot of notes. I'm like, well, Brad, you want to play the melodies? So we actually, the bass is going to have a lot of the melodies, especially in the third one, and we're actually going to play more of the bass parts than the other instruments. So this really definitely features Brad's playing on it. So without further ado, we are borrowing George Gershwin's 3 piano preludes.
Thank you.
Jeremy Smith back there on percussion, playing the rick, frame drum, dumbek, cajon. So we're gonna do a little palate cleanser. That's kind of how I see it. There's like a bazillion notes in the Gershwin parts. And so we're gonna play a bunch of really long, slow things to calm it down. I always think of this as like when you go to the fancy restaurant and they give you the little ginger between the courses, like the palate cleanser. So that's kind of how we see this one. We're gonna play some music from Georgia, actually, now. Not the state, the country. And which, by the way, I think has the nicest handwriting. If you ever look at their script, they have the most interesting script of all the scripts that are out there. This is actually wedding music. I heard a chorus in New York City, an all-women's a cappella group, do this piece. It's called Shenkar Vinaki, and again, it's often done at weddings, traditional Georgian weddings. And I was trying to figure out, like, how could we cop that? And so, why don't we bow the vibraphone? So we're going to bow the vibraphone, four of us, and Genny will be playing the kind of the main melody line on the bass flute. So enjoy. This is Shenkar Vinaki. So if you liked our music, great. I guess you're here and you haven't left. A couple guys left, I'm sure. But for those of you who stayed and want to take it home, we have CDs and records out there. So there's two CDs on the table, an orange and a bluish purple one. We've played almost everything from the blue one and some of the orange one, which is the earlier one. The blue one is available on vinyl, and we actually have red and black vinyl available. So for audiophile type people, we have a lot of fans that like high-grade audio, so it's a very nice pressing. That's a limited edition, so that's out there. There's women's shirts and men's shirts, and we also have a few posters that were printed by the artist that does all of our artwork. So there's a whole mid-century modern kind of graphic theme, and we call it the Exotica for Modern Living series. So hopefully there'll be a long catalog of those at KPR. Hopefully they'll have a shelf for us over time. And so thanks again to Daryl and all the staff from KPR and the recording crew and fans. We really appreciate your support of our music, and of course Derek and the Lead Center. This is going to be our last tune. I hope you guys will stay in touch with us. There's also, I meant to say, there's a mailing list, so even if you don't want to take anything home, please leave your email address out on the mailing list, or just go to orchestrotica.com and sign up. We'd love to keep you, you know, informed if we come back through Kansas and just new records and that type of thing. So once again, I just want to introduce the band real quickly. This is Teb Stevig on oud and resonator guitar. Kenny Skendo on bass flute and shakuhachi and flute. Brad Barrett on the bass. Jeremy Smith on percussion. My name is Brian. You can call me Mr. Ho. Thank you again for coming. Thank you. All right. You asked for it. Now it's really gonna get nuts. Now we're gonna actually play our music. we're gonna play kind of another mixture of old and new. So this tune was actually a ballet piece originally. It's Manuel de Falla, who's a Spanish composer, and this is his Ritual Fire Dance, which I'm sure you've heard the melody before. We retitled it Ritual Mallet Dance, and it's actually a two-for-one tune. So a lot of people always want to hear like more Latin jazz and some of the stuff because of our style. And we don't really play like a lot of Latin jazz, but there was a famous Latin jazz vibraphone player named Cal Schotter. And he wrote a tune. He didn't actually write it. He made a tune called Wachiwada, very famous. It was actually written by Chano Pozo. But the tune is only about 8 bars long, and then it's like 30 minutes of soloing. And so what we said, well, I kind of want to play this ballet piece, so we'll just play both of them at the same time. So you're going to hear Wachiwada and Ritual Fire Dance kind of all put together, and then we actually added some of our own stuff on top of this as well. So this is going to feature Jeremy and I having a little fun on some percussion as well. So this is Ritual Fire Dance, and to kick it off, Genny Skendo is going to show you some amazing things on the bass flute.
Oh,